Yes! It's game time, mother. This is the same intro as last episode.
You're so excited. Woo, James!
Microsoft has taken the wraps off its new game streaming platform, Project xCloud, just 1 week after Google announced its Project Stream. Very reasonable names, fellas. Sony's PlayStation Now already allows streaming to PS4 or PC, but xCloud will allow streaming to Xbox, PC, and mobile devices as well. Microsoft is apparently working on technology that will allow smooth, low-lag streaming over 5G when 5G actually exists. They're also building server racks with four Xboxes worth of hardware to run in the data centers that will power the experience. All this really serves to prove, however, is that once you can play console games on PC, why do you need a console? Lots to think about there.
Wow. I'll see you later.
Intel. You doing okay? Because it almost seems like you paid a testing company to publish questionable benchmarks of your new 9th-gen processors that make AMD's chips look like hot garbage.
Woo!
And that would be weird. But the truth is stranger than fiction. A tech company, ironically named Principal Technologies, was commissioned by Intel to test the company's newly unveiled Core i9-9900K. Their report was released by Intel on Monday, and they've since been accused by tech outlets including Hardware Unboxed, Gamers Nexus, and many others of either manipulating data to make AMD's competing chips look much worse at gaming than they are, or just doing shoddy testing in general. Tech Jesus, Steve Burke from Gamers Nexus, interviewed the co-founder of Principal Technologies to address enthusiast concerns with the testing methodologies used, like failing to create equal testing environments for the Intel and AMD chips, and using Ryzen 7 2700X in game mode, which disables half of the processor's 8 cores.
That's not fair.
No, the debacle has apparently convinced Principal Technologies to redo their tests altogether, and they're gonna update the report once testing is done. But it's probably better just to watch third-party reviews once the embargo lifts on October 19th. Heck, I know I will. Be. And Facebook has revealed their true intentions with the Facebook Portal, a home device with a camera that pipes directly into Mark Zuckerberg's home TV. I mean, it might as well. For all we know, it does. The 10-inch Portal and 15-inch Portal Plus have AI tech that allow the camera to follow you as you move around your home during a video call. Very creepy. And unlike Google's Home Hub, which doesn't have a camera, video calls really are the focus here. Although there's also a number of apps families can use to listen to music, play games, watch Echo shows, or TV shows. It's not an Echo show. There's probably Prime TV.
It's kind of like it.
Don't know. Facebook assures us that video calls are always encrypted and the AI tech only runs locally. There's even a camera cover to soothe customers' privacy concerns. That's all I need. But if we ever do get our hands on one and powered on, it's gonna be really hard to resist. Starting off with a, oh, hi, Mark.
I did not hit her.
I did not. It's time for Quick Bits. Brought to you by Honey. Honey, it's the free shopping tool that finds the best promo codes whenever you shop online at specific sites. But how much money does it save you? A lot. Turns out those of you who have downloaded Honey from the LMG link have already saved over $100,000 in the past few months. It's a free browser extension available on Chrome, Firefox, and Safari that saves you time and money when shopping online at over 30,000 stores. Honey works on Amazon, eBay, Newegg, Razor, Best Buy, Walmart, Jesus, and more. It installs in just 2 clicks. Colton, Brandon, and a few other cool guys like that who work here, they got it and they like it. So get online, get Honey for free right now, and join honey.com/techlinked. On to the quick bits. After apparently fixing the horrible issues with Windows 10 October update, Microsoft is continuing its rollout. Users who lost data as part of an initial batch of updates are encouraged to contact Microsoft support, as their files may not be fully lost. They might only be mostly lost or dead. Non-existent. You're screwed. Google has announced it's shutting down its social network Google+, and no one cares. After a Wall Street Journal report revealed the company has left the private data of hundreds of thousands of Google+ users, there were that many, potentially exposed for months. Google didn't disclose the vulnerability when it first discovered it way back in March due to fears of regulation. And also Facebook was undergoing a similar thing at the time. They didn't want the same thing to happen to them. But now they've decided it's all just not worth it. And I can't say I disagree.
But my circles. You had circles, like friends, your friends were in
Google Plus references won't work on anyone.
I know.
No one used it, damn it.
I know.
Bloomberg News is being criticized by everyone in the tech industry and their dogs for publishing articles detailing a supposed Chinese operation to embed spying hardware in ubiquitous motherboards made by Supermicro. All the sources used in Bloomberg's pieces are anonymous, save for one, a security expert who says he was misinterpreted. Some are accusing Bloomberg of bad reporting, others of defamation against China. This is too complicated for a quick bit. Why is this a quick bit?
It's important.
On to the next one. Here's something simpler. Popular leaker Evan Blass tweeted a photo of what is supposedly the Samsung Galaxy A9 Star Pro, featuring four cameras on the rear. This is probably what the company is going to unveil during its 4X the Fun event tomorrow. Surely this will compete with the Pixel's cameras. There's four of them.
I mean, come on.
Meh?
Yeah.
Meh. And speaking of phones, tonight, Razer is holding an event where they're expected to reveal the Razer Phone 2. It actually might be happening as you watch this, because we're pretty late today. So check it out and then come back here and talk to me about it in the comment section. I'm curious. What do you mean that's not how YouTube works?
It's like a two-way, it's not a two-way thing.
So we're in a dialogue
here.
Yeah. Dialogue. Mm. Yes, it turns out YouTube videos have to end sometime, and that time for this one is now. In case you missed it, Riley actually went to Google's hardware event yesterday and did an on-location tech link, the first one. So check that out, but otherwise, we'll be back, baby, on Friday with some real spicy news.
Yeah!
Spicy. That's the spicy tech news.